Welcome back to my channel. I'm so glad you're back today because it's the weekend. And what does the weekend mean? Yes, you guessed it. We're going to see if I am going to upgrade my list or not so much. I am keeping a wish list, and on the wish list I put stuff up I want to buy in the future. And I have a rule for my low buy that if I have something I want to get, or I just want to spend money on makeup, I at least have to get one thing off the wish list. So that's the wish list, and I am keeping the wish list updated by going through new makeup releases on the Trendmood Instagram page and the Beauty News Instagram page. And I just like to discuss those new makeup releases with you. So that's why I always put one up every week. And I wanted to show you something before I get started. You may notice that I'm wearing a very bold red lip because I have bought the Superstay Ink Crayon in 45 Hustle in Heels. It's the Maybelline one, and I put this on my wish list a few weeks back, or I think 2 weeks back, something like that. So I got one, I took it off the wish list, and I'm really, really happy I got this one because I really love the color. Maybe my teeth look a little bit more yellow, but I don't care because I really love the color. This is just the first time I'm wearing it, so I'm not going to tell you if I like it. No, yes, no. The only thing I can say is that application, because of the tip, is really easy. So that's a thing. You can also sharpen this little tip by using this little sharpener at the end of the crayon, and I think that's very smart of Maybelline to include that. Okay, but without further ado, guys, we go and jump right into the new makeup releases. As usual, I scooched a little closer to the right so I can actually put some pictures up of the stuff I am talking about, so you can actually see what I am, you know, going on about. We are going to start with a Tarte release. I have decided not to read the whole description the brand is giving about their products because it's going to take a very long time. I don't think this is going to be a very long video this week because I don't have an extremely lot to go through, and I am really trying to keep it a little bit more short, so let's go. Okay, Tarte Cosmetics. I am on the Trendmood page, and they have released three new small eyeshadow palettes in the Rainforest of the Sea line. They are going to be $25 each, and they're going to include two foil formulas and one gel glitter topper. The shades are going to be Lunar, Milky Way, and Bahamas. And they are also releasing an H2O gloss in new shades. They are going to be $19 each. And they are going to release a Water Foundation Broad Spectrum, SPF 15 in 30 shades. And that is going to be $39 each. I don't see it in the picture, but apparently there's also a foundation. It's already available, I think, just at everywhere they sell Tarte. To be honest, you know, $25 for a 3-pan eyeshadow palette, and it's just very basic colors. No thank you. No. Gosh, no, dude. If you made it this into one palette, maybe, but then you would have had a lot of redundant shades, so that's a thing. But guys, $25 for 3 eyeshadows, that's insane, that's insane. And to be honest, I don't think Tarte has such great quality eyeshadows anyway. So this is definitely not going on the wish list. Also the glosses, whatever, $19. I can get the same type of colors just going to the drugstore. So $19, no, 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 thank you. I can't really judge the foundation because I don't see it in the pictures. Let's go to Charlotte Tilbury now. I have two releases from Charlotte Tilbury, or releases that are coming up. And the first one I want to talk to you about is a Magic Vanish color. There are going to be color correctors, and they are going to be in the shades Fair, Medium, Tan, and Deep. And they're going to help you diminish under eye puffiness, and it's going to be more, make your skin more luminous and bright. It says it's coming in August, September. So yeah, that is coming. And I think I want to try this in store. I'm not saying I'm going to buy it because I think it's a lot of money for a color corrector. or it will be a lot of money. There's no prices in here, but you know, it's Charlotte Tilbury, so it's going to be a lot of money. But I use color corrector every day for my under eye circles. I use a peach color corrector, and I have a very cheap one at the moment from the home brand from Douglas. And that is working okay. So to be honest, I don't think I should really, I don't really need a very expensive one. But to be honest, it could be a tad bit stronger. I still have, I feel, you know, you're always your own worst critic. So I always, I think that I can use something stronger to really cancel it out. You know, with the lights and stuff, you don't really see how dark my under eye is, but you know. So I want to try this in store and then see if I want to get it, depending on how much it's going to be. Because if it's going to be like 50 bucks, I'm not going to even think about it. And then Charlotte is also going to release a new foundation. I think she did that on YouTube today, or is going to do it today. I'm filming this on Friday, and I think she was going live on YouTube or on Instagram stories, I don't know. Yeah, to release the to show the world the new foundation. It's going to be a foundation with 44 shades, and it's going to be what's it going to be called? Airbrush Flawless, I think. Yeah, the Airbrush Flawless Foundation. It claims to be long wearing, weightless, full coverage, poreless, natural looking, and a matte finish. Natural looking and a matte finish. Okay, well, I seriously need to have that on my skin before I consider buying. It is also going to release on August, September-ish, and I have no idea what it's going to be price-wise, so we'll just have to wait till there's more information. But yeah, it does intrigue me, I have to be honest. I have the Light Wonder foundation. I like that foundation. It's just a very light coverage, so that's something you have to enjoy. I use it mainly in summer because I don't think I need a lot of coverage. And this is going to be fuller coverage, so that is quite interesting, to be honest. I'm keeping an eye out, but I'm not going to put it on the wish list as of yet. Going over to Colored Rain. Colored Rain is about to drop a new sponge. They call it the Flawless Perfecting Sponge. It's going to be $6. Super soft and latex free and cruelty free. So that's coming up. I have tried to order from Colored Rain a few days ago because they have this mystery box at the moment. You can get a $150 value mystery box. There's quite some nice stuff in there. If you're interested in Colored Rain, then you could check out their website. It's going to be $35. The only thing is, if I want to ship that to Holland, it's going to be $15 on top of the $35, and then it's going to be some taxes on top of that, and then it is just going to be twice the cost. So I don't think I am going to do this. The sponge looks a lot like the LA Cosmetics one, but you know, to be honest, how original can a sponge be at this moment? So yeah, I'm just, yeah, not a bad release. I think it's good to have more, have more alternatives for beauty sponges. Not going on the wish list. That's not going to happen. Next up is Urban Decay. Urban Decay is going to release a Stay Naked collection. I think I have been talking about the foundation before, but they are also releasing a concealer. A pro customizer, it's a color corrector. They are going to release some Vice Lip Chemistry. It's a long lasting glossy tint in 12 shades, nudes, pinks, coral red, and they're going to have a build and blend sponge. That sponge is going to be $18, so that's a lot of money. The lip products are going to be $22. And the color corrector is going to be $29. It's going to be in two shades, pure white and pure red. And then the concealer is going to be $29 in 25 shades. And the foundation is going to be 50 shades and $39. And the sponge looks intriguing because it has like a sponge part to it. And like, what's on top of that? I can't really see it. Huh? It looks like they have morphed a silicone sponge into a regular beauty sponge. Sorry, I was like, in your face. Why? Why though? Because I think that this whole silicon sponge thing died a few years back. I don't know. I think it's interesting to see that a lot of brands are releasing color correcting products again, because I think it was a big thing a few years back. Don't ask me when, because I wasn't that much into makeup as I am right now. But I know that there was this color correcting thing popping up everywhere, that you had to put the green on and the peach on and stuff like that. And I think there's something very valuable in color correcting. I don't hate it. As I said, I use it every day under my eyes and sometimes for the redness on my cheeks if I'm feeling really extra. But this is not a collection that is really going to be on my wish list. I don't think it's a bad release, because I like what they are doing. A new foundation is always cool if it's going to be pretty. I don't really get the sponge. Not for $18. It's going to be a little bit too expensive for my taste. And then the color correcting thing, yeah. You know, I can get it somewhere else, so that's okay. Going very shortly into Pat McGrath, I just wanted to mention that on Sephora you can get the Lust Mini Lip Fetish Lip Balm Trio for $25. The pack contains a clear, subtle sheen, a blow up, that's a wondrous warm beige, and Flesh 3, a beautiful bronzed rose. So, you know, you can get that at Sephora for $25. I can't get it because I can't get on Sephora. Yes, now you can feel very bad for me. Going over to Kim K. Kim K is releasing a collection and it's called the Fire Collection. I'm just going to tell you what is in here. I'm not going to read everything, as I said, but this is going to be a bit annoying. There's going to be an eyeshadow palette. It's going to be called So Fire, and it's literally like an S with three O's. So Fire eyeshadow palette for $45. A So Fire eyeliner for $10. So Fire gloss, I think a lip gloss. Yeah, a lip gloss for $18. And then there's the So Fire, I'm not going to say it like that bullshit way. So Fire gloss trio for $42. So Fire eyeliner trio for $25, and the So Fire bundle, so everything together, is going to be $115. It's going to release on July 19th on KKW Beauty. And to be fair, it is a little bit different than usual from her. It's really fiery. I think the name is really fitting to this collection, and I think that's all I really have to say about it. It's not a bad collection. It looks good. I am not about supporting the whole Kardashian empire thing, so I don't buy anything from them, especially because these colors I have like a million times over, so I don't need this. But I just wanted to show you, and I don't think it's a bad release, to be honest. It's not as boring as usual, and yeah, I think it's very true to Kim K. I know a lot of people are saying, you know, the warm colors has been a trend that has been come and gone. But still, this is something that is just fitting for her. So it's really on brand. Next up is Natasha Denona. Natasha Denona is going to release a new mini, and it's going to be the new Mini Tropic palette. It's going to be $25. It's going to be limited edition. So if you want to get it, then you have to be quick. I don't like that life. I get sucked into buying stuff I don't need and I don't want. So I am really just containing myself when it comes to limited edition stuff. I just really think real deep and hard if I want to get it. And this is something I can skip really easily. I love the colors. It looks stunning, really. But I have enough of the same eyeshadows in my collection to create looks I can create with this, so I don't need it, so I'm not going to get it. I don't say it's a bad one, I just say I don't need it. So next thing is something from ColourPop. There's only one release I think this week, so I don't know what happened, but they just released one product, is going to be, it's available now. It's called Just a Tint Lip Crayon. And they release it in bundles, so you can get like two shades in one bundle. I think you can also get them separately if you don't want to get a bundle. It looks really like ColourPop. It looks really fun. The packaging is really cute. The names are really cute. It's just a lip crayon. And I think it's going to be more of a glowy, it's going to be for glowy lips. So it's going to be, I think, more of a glossy, balmy kind of texture. And it says with a hint of a tint. So yeah, I think you can get this or have this in your collection already. I'm not saying it's going to be a bad thing. I'm just saying I don't need it. Yes, you can get them individually. They're going to be $7 each or $12 for a bundle. So you can get a bit of a deal on that one. There's going to be 6 bundles. Coconuts, Give Me a Slice Kit. That's the watermelon one. Your Peach Kit, Cherry and Bright Kit, Dragon My Heart Around Kit, and the Guave Have It Kit. I love the names. It's really nice, it's really fun, it's really summery, and it is not going on the wish list. Next up is Milani. Milani has released, I think I have been talking about one of these palettes last week. I don't know for sure, that one wasn't really intriguing to me. But they have released 2 more, or at least they have added, or they were already there and I didn't see them. I don't know. But they have released, because it's available now at Milani Cosmetics, and I think you can get it anywhere they sell Milani, I don't know for sure, but oh no, it says will be available this month at Walmart as well. So, there are 3 palettes and they are going to be $19.99 each. One is in Gilded Ember Hyper. The other one is called Gilded Jade Hyper. I think that's the green one. And you also have the Gilded Violet Hyper. That's the purple one. It's, I don't think it's a bad release, especially for the green one. The green one is quite intriguing. I love the minty color and the greenish color on the right side down. And also that middle shimmer, not the middle shimmer, but the top row and then the middle shimmer. It's like a murky, mustardy, greenish kind of a color. So I think that's pretty nice. The swatches also look cool. So it's a very nice release, I think. I thought the warm one was a bit too boring to me. Yeah, like the Kim K thing, I already have a lot of those colors, so I wouldn't need it. It's kind of the same with the green one as well. I'm not going to get it because I have these colors now. Because I have been buying a lot of green eyeshadows and a lot of these murky mustard yellowy eyeshadows. So I don't have a need for this one. It just, yeah, it captured my eye. It was, I think it's nice. And also the violet one is looking pretty cool as well. You've got some deeper shades so you can really deepen up your look. You can really take it from day to night. So yeah, it's not a bad release, I think. It's just not something I'm going to put on the wish list. But you know, $19.99 is not even a very bad price for a palette like that, to be honest. This is cool. This is House Labs, or House Laboratories, I don't know. It's just a makeup collection from Lady Gaga. And I'm not really understanding how this is going to work, so I don't know if I want to have it or if I'm going to put it on the wish list, yes or no. I'm just going to put up some pictures. And what I think is cool, because I saw some media pictures and also the pictures on the model, it looks really grungy and really express yourself in the way you want to express yourself, almost like Madonna-like inspiration. And I think there are going to be some lip liners. There is going to be a shimmer powder that you can, I think, use on your eyes. There's going to be a lip gloss. So, yeah, I don't really understand what it's about. But they say on launch there will be 9 different duos. And there will be 2 lip liners, $26. 2 glosses, $32. 2 glam attacks, $36. And 6 three-piece sets that are going to be $49, that include the REP or the RIP lip liner, Le Riot gloss, and the Glam Attack. It's going to be available for pre-order on the 15th of July on the House Lab site and on Amazon. Yeah, I don't know. You know, I'm just going to wait with any opinion until I know more. Because this is just a little bit jumbled up and I really don't understand what is going on. It looks cool. The marketing images look cool. So let's wait and talk about it in another week when we have a little bit more information. Next thing is by iHeartRevolution, Makeup Revolution brand. This is fun. I think this is fun. I'm not going to get anything from this, but it looks fun. They have gone into the whole food-inspired makeup, and they are going to release a tasty pizza palette, also a tasty chili palette, and a tasty avocado palette. These are going to be three eyeshadow palettes with like the colors inspired by the vegetable or the food they are representing. So in the pizza one is quite boring. Grays and yellows and a little bit of terracotta color. That's weird. Okay, the red pepper one, you have some reds, you have some corals, you have some yellows, you have some nice shimmers, a purple and a blue. I don't know why the purple and the blue are in there. Maybe the blue for the stem, but okay. And then I think the avocado palette is more, is the most on or in theme, because that's quite green. And a lot of shades I think are almost the same. But yeah, you know, it's Makeup Revolution, so yeah, we could not be too critical of that. And they also have, I think these are blushes. Yeah, you have a fruity highlighter. The banana and the pineapple are going to be highlighters. And the strawberry and the peach are fruity blushes. And they look so fun. I have no idea how it is going to hold up if you're going to swirl your brush in those pans, but they look so much fun. Don't they look fun? I think they look fun. I'm not going to get anything of this, but it looks fun. Then Revlon. Revlon have, they have created a limited edition Mrs. Maisel Marvelous Super Lustrous Collection inspired by Maisel TV. I think this is a series. I have no clue. I'm sorry, but these are, I think it's going to be, it's going to be a bundle. Yeah, I think they are going to release two bundles. One is a red one. It's called Take the Stage Red. They're going to be $20. There are going to be three red lipsticks in there, Cherries in the Snow, Certainly Red, Fire and Ice. And the other pack is Stand Up Nude, also $19.99. And they are going to be the colors Pink Truffle, Rum Raisin, and a Blushing Mauve. So they look cool, especially the red ones. They look really, really nice. The nudes, I'm not really... I'm always drawn to like mauve-y, nudie mauve-y, pinkish, what you call it? Lipsticks, and I buy them and I don't really wear them, or I think I have now so many mauve-y, nudie lip colors that I don't need them. And if I see them like this, then I'm noticing right now that they are not really screaming my names. So the red ones, yeah, they are, because they're different and they're fun. It's just that I'm waiting on the Lisa Eldridge. She's going to release her or re-release her red bundle. And I'm going to get those, so I'm not going to get this. But it looks really fun. I think it's a nice release. Even though I don't know the series. Next up is Burberry. They are... they have launched a new lip product. It's called the Burberry Kisses Lacquer. And I think this is going to be more of a liquid lip, because it's going to be really long lasting. It's going to have a glossy laminated finish. So you have a high shine, full coverage in one stroke. Sure. Yeah, and it's going to be an innovative non-drying formula that delivers bold color with a comfortable gel-like texture. And they are going to be in 12 shades. and they are going to be $37 each. They are already available on the Burberry website and on Nordstrom, maybe also in store, I don't know, doesn't say. They look really, really stunning, I'm sorry. It's just the packaging with the gloss and then the product looking like this point. It's really aesthetically really pleasing, really. But I don't like liquid lips. I don't like the formula of liquid lips. And I think that $37 for something I normally just don't enjoy, I'm not going to get this on the wish list. So the colors look really pretty and I think they're going to be stunning. It's just, I'm going to skip. I have been talking about this, I think last week or the week before. Buxom is releasing eyeshadow palettes and I showed you, there were more products in the collection and they were already showing one palette. They were telling about one palette and you saw this mauve one in the background. And now they have launched both of the eyeshadow palettes. It's the Boss Babe Dolly. It's $39 and it's the Boss Babe Betty. And I think that the Dolly is the more mauve one and the Betty is the more goldeny one. And yeah, I'm just going to put the pictures up on the screen. They look pretty. It's not for me, but they look pretty. Then Glossier. Glossier has released two new shades to their lip gloss range. They have one that's an holographic, and they have a red. And they have red for a subtle sheer tint. So you have like a sheer red gloss on your lips. They look quite nice, to be honest. Very, very glossy. And I think that the red one is in the swatch, it almost looks a little, it looks a little more pinkish. So I don't know how that is going to perform on the lips because it's the swatch is on a girl with darker skin. So I don't know what that would do on lighter skin or on lips on lighter skin. Yeah. Yeah, it's lip gloss. It looks nice. It's very high shiny. It looks cool. Glossier is not something I can get very easily, so I'm not going to put it on the wish list. But if you can get it, now you know. It's going to be $14 each. Maybe that's a nice thing to know. And it's already available, so go knock yourself out. This is the last thing I want to talk to you about, and this is the only thing this week I'm going to add to my wish list. It's new from Pixi. It's the Retinol and Jasmine collection. And it's created with time-release retinol and anti-inflammatory jasmine. It's available now at pixiebeauty.com. I am hoping it's coming to Hudson Bay in Holland. That's the only store that sells Pixi in store. I hope it's coming there because I want to just get it easily in store. And I'm really intrigued by this because I am not using retinol in my skincare at the moment. And I want to start with retinol. And I think maybe, just a sec. Well, that was easy. I already have one. I already have the retinol tonic. I bought this in England. I put it in my honeymoon haul. That's really funny. I was looking at this little, you know, the tonic one. I was like, don't I have this stuff? I do. So, yeah, I wanted to put it on the wish list, but I don't need to because I already have this. I'm going to start off with trying this one and then I'm going to see if I want to add something to my skincare next to this. I'm still going through a glow tonic, so I'm going to finish that one first and then I'm going to go over to this one. I'm going to tell you what is in the range. There's going to be a retinol jasmine cleanser. There's going to be a retinol tonic, this one. There's going to be a jasmine oil blend. There's going to be an overnight retinol oil. That also sounds interesting. There's going to be a retinol jasmine lotion and there's going to be a retinol eye cream. That sounds scary, to be honest, but I like this. I like Pixi. I like the fact that they are coming out with a retinol collection, and I think it's really smart to have retinol and jasmine. If jasmine is inflammatory or anti-inflammatory, then that's very smart because it just can balance each other out. And the purple, the lavender purple, it's really cute. So I'm a sucker for cute. I'm a sucker for cute packaging. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Okay, guys, that was it. That was it. I'm done. I'm already done. I hope this is going to be a little bit of a shorter video. If I see the time on my camera, I think I have done quite nicely on just not rambling on about every little release. So yeah, let me know what you think of anything I have shown. Do you have the same opinion as me? Or are you like, girl, why are you not getting this? It's great, I want to have it. Please let me know down below. Also, you can check out the complete wish list in the description box. I'm not going to add this. I haven't added anything this week. This is crazy. I haven't added anything. But maybe that's a good thing. You know, I don't have to add something every week. That's not a good thing. It's a good thing I didn't add anything. So yeah. Thank you so much for watching. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. And I hope I see you in my next video. Bye!